Hello, my name is Wong Ping. Did you know that a well-written report significantly increases the chance of your bug bounty report being accepted? As bug bounty hunters, we spend a lot of time finding bugs on the program. Why not spend a little bit more time to ensure that your reports are well-written, to the point that the triage team members are always looking forward to receiving your reports? Many bug bounty beginners think that writing a report is a no-brainer, but little did they expect that the reports could have earned more bounties or could have been accepted or maybe even get rewarded much earlier. A well-written report makes a huge difference. Over the years, I have submitted over 1,000 reports across various bug bounty platforms and channels. Recently, I reviewed them and came up with 9 report writing tips which I believe would greatly benefit all researchers, especially bug bounty beginners and aspiring bug hunters. In this first video of a 3-part series, I will be sharing 3 of the tips to writing good bug bounty reports. Tip number 1, don't assume. Always treat triage team members as newbies. This is especially important because many times reports were closed as informative simply because the triage team members do not understand what you were trying to report. It can be due to many reasons, but most of the time, the problem lies in you, the researcher. You might be making too many assumptions. For example, maybe you provided too little information, expecting them to already be well-versed in the CVE or the bug type that you were reporting. But the truth is, you should never assume. Well, regardless of which bug bounty platform, triage team members are human, not AI. Human makes mistakes. There are times when they are too tired or they may read the information wrongly if you don't provide them in a clear manner. There is also a possibility that this was their first time seeing the particular CVE or the bug type that you have reported. Remember, you only have one chance. Most of the time, once your report was being closed as informative, it will be hidden into a different inbox filter and the triage team member may not revisit them again. Therefore, don't risk your report getting dumped into the informative filter. You can do it by helping them to understand your report better by providing a more detailed context of the CVE or bug class that you were reporting. Always write your report in clear manner, write a concise summary, and provide sufficient steps to reproduce it. Make it as easy to understand as possible. Treat them like newbie. Even though some of them might be much more experienced than you, this is because you won't know who will be reading your report. Personally, I have had reports that were initially closed as informative by the triage team members, but subsequently, it gets reopened and accepted by the program because one of them went to review my report and noticed that this is something that they actually want to fix. Tip number 2, be flexible in your report submissions. They don't always need to be standardized. For people who have worked with me in the cybersecurity industry or read my bug bounty reports previously, they know that I am always very detailed in my report write-up. However, over the years of bug hunting, I also learned to be flexible and I am telling you that this is super important, especially when a program is new or when you are participating in a challenge. This is because they can be very time sensitive. For example, there is a new bug bounty program that invites researchers to find bugs in their test environment instance. It is very common for programs to create one test environment and let all invited researchers share it. After you set up your account, you log in and found a bug in your first 5 minutes of testing and then you start drafting a report. However, other researchers may see your test results and submit a report before you. Aha! The bounty will go to the first person who submitted the report. Therefore, it is crucial that for time-sensitive reports like those I mentioned earlier, you should always write your report detailed enough to be understood by the triage team members, but not to the point that it takes too much of your time writing it. You can always submit a new comment later to provide more details. However, if you do this, try to provide the information before the triage team members read your initial report, so as not to confuse them. Tip number 3, Be open-minded and respect the team members from the triage team and program team. Sometimes, the triage team members may ask for a bunch of information, clarification, or claim that they cannot reproduce the bug. In fact, most of this information may have already been mentioned in your initial report, or they are basic stuff that you would expect them to know, such as how to create accounts of different roles and etc. This often leads to frustration. But here's the thing, you spent so much time and effort finding the bug and writing the report. Are you going to let your frustration take over and have this report closed as informative just because you do not want to explain further to teach the triage team members how to reproduce the bug? Honestly, I'd rather they ask questions than just simply closing my report as informative and not replying to my further comments. It is a better outcome for us as researchers to provide as much information as possible to help them reproduce the bug. For access control related bugs, there are several occurrences whereby I recorded video tutorials to teach the triage team members how to set up the different accounts with different roles. One is to guide them since they are pretty overwhelmed by the number of roles on the application. Two is to help them reproduce the bug faster so that my reports can also be triaged faster. The bug bounty industry is quite small. Some of the triage team members may be new to the industry when they start the role. Give them a break, help them understand, help them learn. Respect them by answering their inquiries gracefully. As long as there is mutual respect, you will have a pleasant experience participating in bug bounty programs. Don't forget, if you are active on any bug bounty platforms, you will keep encountering the same few triage team members no matter which programs you participate in. Therefore, there is no point in being constantly frustrated. Build a friendly relationship with mutual respect and be receptive towards the questions raised, no matter how trivial they are. With this, I have come to the end of my first video of the 3-part series for 9 tips to writing good bug bounty reports. I hope the information I have shared are useful to you, especially bug bounty beginners and aspiring bug hunters. Remember, writing a good bug bounty report is not a no-brainer. It is a skill that all researchers should master in order to maximize report acceptance rate. If you liked this video, please like and subscribe. For more bug bounty report writing tips, please stay tuned to my next video. If you have any report writing tips that you want to share with others, please add them in the comments. Have fun and keep hunting!